Welcome to the Manage Impact Development Training for Operations Manager. My name is Brian Wren, and I'm a knowledge engineer with Microsoft, focusing on System Center and cloud technologies. This module is titled Introduction to Authoring Tools. In this module, we'll discuss the different options that you have for creating a Manage Impact. We'll spend most of the time on the Visual Studio authoring extensions, which is the primary tool used for Manage Impact development, and which is the focus of this training. But we want to put this in context of the other tools that are available. The first authoring tool that most people become familiar with is the Operations Console, and there's a considerable amount of authoring that it can perform. It's completely wizard-driven, requires minimal skill. You also need no knowledge of the underlying Manage Impact structure. You're limited to a finite set of scenarios, though, and you can't design your own service model. So the Operations Console is primarily used for ad hoc monitoring and administering existing Manage Impacts, creating things like overrides and groups. The Authoring Console was our primary tool for Operations Manager 2007, and this is the main tool that we used in trainings and conferences over the last few years. It allows you to design your own service model and any custom monitoring scenario you require. It has some wizards for common scenarios and provides you with a combination of UI and access to XML for more custom work. This tool had some limitations, though, and it's no longer being updated. You can still use it if you prefer, but you'll be limited to Operations Manager 2007 schema. So you can't create new elements like dashboards, and you can't import or reference a Manage Impact using the OpsMan 2012 schema. The tool that we'll be focusing on for the remainder of the training is Visual Studio Authoring Extensions. This is an add-on to Visual Studio, so we can take advantage of many of the professional development features that Visual Studio provides. We do have to work directly with a significant amount of XML, but we're going to get features like IntelliSense to help us out. And we do have templates for some elements, which will save us from XML, as well as some other interesting features. Since this is going to be our main tool going forward, we'll spend some more time going through its features, as well as do some initial work with it. Before we get into that detail, though, let's have a look at where we can use each of these tools. As I mentioned in the previous module, Ops Manager 2007 and 2012 have a different schema. 2012 can use both schemas, but 2007 can only use the original schema. To determine which tools you can use, you need to understand which schemas they work with. When you create Manage Impacts in the Ops Console, they're written directly to the Operations Manager database, so there's no schema to worry about. When you export it, though, that's when the XML file gets generated. And it should come as no surprise that the 2007 console will export in 2007 content, and the 2012 console will export in 2012. The Authoring Console can only work with the 2007 schema. Now, Ops Manager 2012 will import those Manage Impacts with no problem, but you won't be able to use new features such as dashboards and binary attachments. You also won't be able to import any Manage Impacts that you might have exported from the 2012 console, and you can't use any of the 2012 versions of Library Manage Impacts as references. To do those things, you're going to need to move to the Visual Studio tool. Now, Visual Studio Authoring Extensions will work with all formats. You can both create a new Manage Impact using either schema, or you can import either one. In addition to that, you can combine multiple formats in a single solution, which is useful when you want a Manage Impact that will install in Ops Manager 2007, but includes separate MP files for 2012 only elements, such as dashboards. So let's have a quick overview of VSAE before we actually jump into it and have a look. There are three basic ways that you're going to work with Manage Impact elements. First is a Manage Impact fragment. This is a chunk of XML that includes one element or several, depending on how you choose to break things up. When you build the project, then all the fragments will be compiled together to produce a single XML file. This allows you to organize things in a much easier manner than working with the file in its entirety. Now, some elements will have templates available. Monitors and views are two quick examples. Templates allow us to configure an element through setting properties as opposed to working directly with the XML. When you save your settings, the appropriate XML is created for you. Snippets provide a way to create multiple similar elements, such as a bunch of rules. You create a snippet template that has the XML that's common for all the elements, as well as variable for those values that will need to be unique. You can then create a new element by simply creating a new entry in a table. So we're going to get experience with each of these as we go through the different exercises. In addition to authoring Manage Impacts, the VSAE ships with different Manage Impact tools that will help with editing and testing. We'll have a look at each of these in a moment, but let's just quickly walk through each one. First is the Management Pack browser, which will allow you to inspect all of the contents of the current Management Pack project in addition to any reference Management Packs. This is very useful in identifying the details of elements in other MPs that you might need access to. Next is the MP Similar, which is a very useful tool, which will allow us to test workflows before we actually install them in the MP. In addition to that, we can inspect the data output at each module in the workflow. That's something you probably won't quite appreciate yet, but you definitely will once we start getting into custom workflows. And we'll make extensive use of the MP Simulator as we create different rules and monitors and discoveries through the exercises in the training. Finally, we have the Best Practices Analyzer, which will inspect your Management Pack to ensure that it follows best practices. This includes things like how frequently workflows are run, making sure that display strings are in place, and that sort of thing. In addition to just finding those issues, it'll actually help you quickly correct them, in some places doing it automatically. So now let's actually jump down into the tool and do a quick overview of some of these different features. So here I have Visual Studio Authoring Extensions open. And in this case, I have opened the solution for the Management Pack that we'll be working on throughout the rest of the modules. This is actually the completed version, but just so I can illustrate some of the points that I talked about. And I'll just give a brief overview here, as opposed to really go through any lessons as far as creating the different elements. We'll obviously go through that as we do our different exercises. But you can see here I have four different projects in my solution, and each of these represents a separate MP file. And so what's nice about this, when you were using the authoring console before, you could only work with one of these files at a time. And in this case, my Management Pack is comprised of four different files, and I can work with them all at once. So let's drop down into one of these, and of course, as we go through the lessons, I'll describe what these are and what the different elements are, and we'll create most of this. So you can see, though, that basically I have this organized in a way that makes sense to me. I've grouped my different elements together according into some different folders, and this is completely arbitrary how I chose to do this. Just I, as the developer, this is the way that makes sense to me. So I'm going to open up here. This is an MP fragment that has a couple of classes defined. It actually has two classes in here as well. Well, here are the two classes. And then down below, we have all the different display strings that go along with those classes and their properties. And again, this is just the way that I chose to break things up. I could have put each of these in their own MP fragment. I could have put all the different classes and relationships in one big giant fragment if that's what I chose to do. In this case, these two really are similar or make sense for me to group them together in my MP, for me to work with them together. And I just include their definition along with the display strings that go along with them so I can work with them as a unit. Over here, let's open up. Here's some different computer roles, some other classes that I have. And here's a bunch of relationships that I chose to hold over here. So again, the nice thing about using Visual Studio as opposed to when we use the authoring console is I can organize all of these different elements and break things down into a way that makes sense to me. I have no requirement at all to have a fully functional completed Management Pack at this point. All of the XML here does certainly have to be correct. The different sections have to be correct, but I really only have to include those specific sections of the XML that I want within that fragment. And then, of course, when we do the build, all of them will come together to build the final product. So let's just have a look at a couple other things here. We'll go down into the monitoring one, and let's have a look at some monitors. We'll have a look at some templates. Here's some queue monitors. So you see here, this is three different monitors. This is what we call a template group. And so rather than having to deal directly with the XML, in this case, because we provide a template for a monitor, we don't have a template for a class, I can just work with the different properties of this monitor down here. And I won't step through them. We're going to obviously create a monitor or two in our different lessons. And we'll go through most of these properties here and explain them in pretty good detail. But you can see, rather than having to work directly with the XML, I can actually just select different options. The one place where I am going to have to deal with it is the configuration. So if you look at monitors and rules in a Management Pack, I can create very customized workflows. And so the configuration will vary quite significantly between different elements. because of that, there's really no good way to create a consistent UI that we can put on top of it. So for the configuration, for the detail of each, we basically just launch a window where we type in the XML for that. And so this shows a little bit of XML that I would have to work with. But to just demo something here real quick that allows us to work with it, I'm going to delete that out. And you'll notice if I just type a bracket, I'm getting IntelliSense understands exactly the different properties that I need to provide when I configure this monitor. So in this case, it wants interval seconds. I need a sync time. I'll go ahead and leave that blank. And I won't sit here and type these out, but just really to display the point that even though we are having to work with the XML, we are getting some nice features like IntelliSense, so we don't have to become experts in the actual schema. And there are a variety of different features around the authoring extensions that are going to provide us with help like this, and obviously we'll see that as we go through those exercises. So I'll cancel that here. And let's have a look, just one last thing, we'll have a look at the concept of a snippet. So what snippets do, as I mentioned, is it allows us to take several very similar elements and create a template for them. So in this case, I have just five different, these are simple alert rules, and they're just looking for a particular event, firing off an alert. But they each have a unique name, they have a different event number they're looking for, different severity alert that I want to provide. You can see I can select that from a drop-down. I provide a unique display name, description is, and you can see the different properties I need to provide. And where we've got that defined here is in this snippet template, where this is the XML for that alert rule. And everywhere where you see yellow, these are places where we're defining the different properties in the table that I had. So rather than having to go through and copy XML and finding those places where it has to be unique, or certainly I could create a template group of rules and go and change the different properties, this makes it very quick and easy for us to create a whole set of similar rules. So in this case, if I wanted to create a new one, I just say add new item, and I go ahead and type that in. And then when you actually save, what's happening is, let's have a look here, this is the full XML. We've taken that template and basically applied it to all of the different rows in that table that I provided. So again, makes it very easy, another feature provided by the authoring extensions that makes building the management pack very easy to do. So while we're in here, let's have a quick look at a couple of the tools that I mentioned before. I'm going to go ahead and close that out. We'll have a look at the management pack browser. So what this provides us is the MP browser lets us browse through all of the management pack files that are in our current solution, as well as any of the other management packs that they reference. And so what's nice is I could go into something, for instance, the Windows library here, and I can have a look at the different elements it's got in it. So I might need to see what classes are available. These are classes I might want to use as a base class. What properties are available on them? I can see things, for instance, here's a network adapter, and I can see very quickly here are the properties that are on a network adapter. Might be a class that I need to use in my project. I can go down and look at the type library. I can look at different monitor types that are available. I can see the full XML for each of those types. I can look at the different properties that they're going to require. I can get an idea of what they do, how they work. Well, obviously, as we get into monitor types and module types, we'll see that. Here are the module types that I have available to me. So again, a nice service of all the different management packs that I might be working with in this solution, and a very quick way to go and inspect them and look at some details I need. The other feature that this helps us work with is if I take my current management pack, so here's the monitoring one, here are the different monitors that are in that MP file. So let's just, I'm not actually gonna do something with it, but very quickly, obviously, here's the XML for this monitor here. But if I right click, here's where the MP simulator is. And that's what I mentioned before. This is the tool that will actually allow me to simulate this particular workflow, provide different properties to it, we'll run it, we'll validate its output. We can actually look at its output at each step of the way. We can try different values and say, if we discovered this value, would I get the health state that I expect? So great, great tool. For doing testing of our MP and inspection of our output, and we'll make use of this throughout the lessons as we do discoveries and monitors and rules, we'll use the MP simulator in each one. So I won't actually walk through it right now. We'll go through that in a later lesson, but I just really wanted to give an overview of how we would launch that and how the different tools are integrated into the VSAE. So anyway, that's just a very quick overview, a little bit of an orientation for Visual Studio authoring extensions. What we'll do in the next lesson is actually start with a clean slate and create ourselves a new management pack with all of the different projects that I showed, and actually go through the different properties that we set. We'll create references and the whole bit. So until we get to that module, this concludes this one. Thank you.